It's winning formula time on Vikings Game Plan. We are happy to welcome former Vikings linebacker, current analyst for the Vikings Radio Network, Ben Leber, onto the set here at TCO Studio, joined by Ron Johnson and Wobby. And we are going to handle some pertinent Vikings and NFC North related topics at the close of Vikings Game Plan. We begin here. 13 wins generally gets you home field advantage throughout the playoffs. Ben, for the Vikings to get that 13, how do they do it?
Well, they got to play like a first place team. You know, that's the schedule that they've got this year. Rams, Eagles, Saints, and then the Patriots, along with the teams in your division. So you have to win those games and show up like a first place team.
I think this is cliche and we say it all the time, but this year especially, given what Ben said, the Vikings schedule, to get home field advantage, you got to win your games at home.
Yeah.
Because you look at the Vikings road schedule and there are some toughies in there, including games at Seattle and at New England late in the year. So if you can take care of business at home and then take your chances on the road, I think you got a leg up.
When the schedule comes out in April, how much do you guys freak out over the schedule? I mean, granted, at LA, at Philadelphia, Belichick in December.
From what standpoint? Like, well, as a player, I looked at it from, like, what cold games am I going to play?
Yes.
You know, where are we going to go?
Right.
You know, thankfully, this year, they don't have any cold games in December. But that's the first thing I looked at when I was a player.
Yeah, I mean, you look at the Patriots going to the Patriots in December. That's the one game that I have that's going to probably be tough weather-wise. I mean, you never know what's going to happen down there.
Yep.
And then there's the rest of the schedule. I think Ben said it perfectly. The Rams, the Saints, the Eagles. I mean, going the road with the Rams, going the road with the Eagles, I mean, that's tough. You have the Saints coming here, so the whole Minneapolis miracle is going to be the shadow, the ghost of it. Honestly, I had them at 12-4. So getting to 13, I think you have to beat Green Bay twice.
Now, Ron Johnson mentioned the New Orleans Saints. If you lay out the NFC, the pantheon of the NFC, who do you think is the team to beat to get to the Super Bowl? I think it's the Saints.
I agree. I think it's the Saints. That's who I had. I mean, you look at the Rams. I just think with all those pieces, it's tough to get all those pieces to gel together and become a great team. They were good last year. They're going to be really good again, but I think the Saints are still the team. I mean, they have Alvin Kamara. They have Mike Thomas. And Drew Brees is still there. And now Teddy Bridgewater can tell them a little bit about what the Vikings have been doing.
Yeah.
So I think it's the Saints.
I'm with the Saints as well. They were the better team in the second half of last year's division game. I mean, they outplayed the Vikings. Mm-hmm. And I don't think that that was a fluke. I think that there's a legit football team that has a secondary that's even more experienced than it was last year. You mentioned Drew, you mentioned Kamara. Ingram's on suspension, but he'll be back. I think that offense is going to keep plugging away, keep being efficient. You still got Drew Brees, and that defense is going to be even better than it was last year.
That's where I was going to go with the Saints, is the difference for me in the Saints is their defense. I mean, Marshawn Lattimore in particular, how good of a player is he, and Cameron Jordan? I mean, the Saints have a really good defense now, and Ben's right. In the second half of that divisional round playoff game, that was a titanic battle between two really good teams. So I do think it's the Saints. I think the Vikings and the Packers are in that conversation.
Yeah, we certainly don't mean to disrespect the Super Bowl champion Philadelphia Eagles, you know, or Green Bay. Aaron Rodgers is back, Ben. I know it's a massive difference having A-Rodge, but overall, does that legitimately make Green Bay a Super Bowl quality team?
Yeah, I think it does. The running game should be better. It's getting better with every year. But as long as you have Aaron, you've got a chance.
Now, speaking of quarterbacks, Kirk Cousins will make his regular season U.S. Bank Stadium debut. We saw him in the game against Jacksonville. We saw him light it up against Seattle. This is a big game, not only for the Vikings, but for Kirk Cousins. Take a deep breath. It's going to be loud. A lot of expectations on you. What do you guys think?
I'm excited. I talked to Daryl Hazel and I talked to Todd Downing. We've talked about the run pass option, the RPO. We've talked about it over and over and over again. We didn't see a ton of it in the preseason. I'm excited to see what that looks like. What is this offense going to look like? Is it going to be a shell of what the Eagles did last year with a little bit of DeFilippo twist on it?
Yep.
Or is this going to be a whole different offense that we've never seen before? Offensive coordinators are extremely creative nowadays. You have to be in order to beat some of these top defenses. So I just want to see Kirk Cousins, and I want to see him come and command the huddle. He has to be the captain. He has to get the cadence in, and he has to check out of plays that I don't think Case Keenum could do last year. I think Kirk Cousins, I'm excited to see what he's going to do.
He's going to have a good game. I wouldn't put it as like a 350-yard game. I still think that there's going to be some baby steps with this offense.
Yeah.
And I think that you should take that appropriate steps in the first game. I think it's going to be a shorter passing game. I don't think they're going to air it out as much as maybe they talked about. We still didn't see in the preseason what a healthy Dalvin Cook in the full four quarters is going to look like. We did not see them throw the tight ends very much. We did not see Adam Thielen very much, except for their third preseason game. So there's a lot of weapons that he did not utilize in the preseason that I want to see how that all kind of mixes in.
Yeah, it really excites me what he just said.
Kirk got a lot of money. He's a really good player, and he's got John DeFilippo, who's also new, and there's a lot of pressure and a lot of eyes on those guys. But I got good news for both of them. We have the best defense in the NFL, an awesome home field advantage. I mean, there were games where Kirk Cousins and the Redskins, I mean, they scored 30 against the Vikings.
Yeah.
And lost. Okay, that's not going to happen here. So we do expect a lot from Kirk, but I don't think it's as big of a load for him to carry as the contract that he has might indicate.
So when we look at the NFC North, we think Vikings, Packers, Packers, Vikings. It's probably going to go one of two ways. Khalil Mack is now in the division. One of the best pass rushers in the NFL from the Oakland Raiders. How does that impact things?
You look at him and Hicks now, that's 20 sacks on one team now.
Wow.
But then as far as touchdowns, there was only 18 touchdowns thrown on them last year. So now you add an even stronger pass rush. This is already a decent defensive team. I think the biggest issue was Mitchell Trubisky could not sustain drives.
Yeah.
So the defense was on the field way too long. I don't think that's going to happen as much this year. I think he's going to take that next step to, you know, move the ball a little bit more, him and Tariq Cohen. And then now Khalil Mack can just eat. So
you have the Bears to win the division.
I don't have them to win the division, but I don't think they're going to be cellar dwellers.
Bears game plan loves what he's
I think the Lions are going to be the bottom.
What do you think?
I think he definitely changes the division. And it really shifts your perspective on a snap-by-snap basis, especially when you start getting into passing situations of knowing where he's at. And if the Bears are smart, they're going to move him around a little bit. They're going to see what he can do on both sides of the ball. I think he does change things. You know, it's sort of like Lawrence Taylor. You know, I'm not going to put him in that category, but when you talk to the older generation about playing against Lawrence Taylor, when all the dust was settled, they're like, that guy changed the game just by his presence. And I think that's what Khalil Mack
did. Yeah, easy with the older generation stuff for the 52-year-old now, Bobby.
The only good news about all of this is that Aaron Rodgers and Matthew Stafford have to play him twice also. Other than that, it's all bad news.
And Khalil Mack also very good against the run. Let's close with this quick hitter. Dalvin Cook or Latavius Murray? Who scores more rushing touchdowns and why for the Vikings? Ben, you're first.
You know, I think that the conventional wisdom is to go with the bigger back in goal line situations. I think Dalvin Cook ends up having more touchdowns, and it's because he can catch the ball in the red zone. I don't think they necessarily have to get inside the 5-yard line to be like, all right, Latavius is in, we're just going to hand the ball off.
Yeah.
I think there's going to be more touchdowns scored from Dalvin on about the 15 to the 10-yard line, just catching some F angles and stuff out of the back.
And there might be more explosive runs from Dalvin too, like the 40-yard runs or the 30-yard runs where he gets to the end zone. But Ben made a good point about the Vikings' short yardage running game and goal line running game last year was very good. And that was a point of emphasis that Zimmer had. And it was a big part of it was Latavius being good in those areas. So he's still gonna get his, but I would go with Dalvin.
I'm gonna say, if it's pass and run, it's going to be Dalvin.
Correct.
Because we know Latavius has not scored one in his career. He
keeps
promising you he's going to do it. Haven't seen it yet. Yeah. But if we're just talking run, I'm going to go with, like Ben said, the conventional thinking. I think that, one, early on in the season, we're not going to see as much of Dalvin Cook because he's still going to be trying to work through that knee. And then Latavius on short yardage, I mean, it's the Tay train. You got to give him the ball. So it's going to be him in the red zone. And, I mean, if you look at this offense, a lot of the early Denver game, you know, it's deep balls to Stephon Diggs down to the 1-yard line, and then it's Latavius Murray.
Ron Johnson, Ben Leber, Wobby, I'm Paul Allen. That's a winning formula on behalf of the Vikings Entertainment Network and all of us here at Vikings Game Plan. Thanks for watching.